The Mecha Comet is a modular Linux handheld computer.
Right.
We went with the idea that we see a lot of consumer electronics which are, you know, wonderful computers, but they are logged into the ecosystem of a smartphone OS, right? It's meant for consumers, it's meant for calling and doing all sorts of things, right? But then, if you remember the 90s and the early 20s, where we used to have computers where we were allowed to, you know, open it up, modify stuff, how can we bring that same thing back, but in a compact form factor? Right, so we went with a handheld form factor. We wanted to keep it portable. This is running Debian Linux, right? It's running our own GUI. We've open sourced the GUI as well. The good thing about the Comet is everything that you see here is available for customization. So we have open sourced our CAD files, the bootloader, the kernel, the image generation, even the flash tool is open source, right? And we are right now supporting the Linux kernel 6.6. One of the things that we did with this and which we really like is the magnetic snap. Okay, so we took the 40-pin IOs, we have exposed the 40-pin IO. This, though it is 40-pin, it doesn't really match the Raspberry Pi, right? But you can actually extend this to use Raspberry Pi hats as well, right? So now we are trying to make this keyboard. This is still a model right now, but the idea is if you snap it in, the OS is going to detect it as a USB device, right? The key idea here is that we converted a USB port into just 4 pogo pins. So as soon as you snap it in, it is as if you are plugging in a USB port. Device, right? So it is, you don't need special drivers, you don't need special hardware, right? Any USB based controller would work, and the specs of the extensions are open source, so people can 3D print them, design them on their own, publish the files and make it available for rest of the users, right? So you could, like, if you're done with the keyboard or the terminal, right, you could swap the gamepad, right? So now you could essentially, this is the lock screen, I can switch between apps, go back to terminal, I can come here and it runs Doom as well.
That's the most important.
Yeah, of course. So while the Doom gets loaded, we can actually switch between applications. And yeah, here you go. We've kept repairability as very important to us, right? We want, unlike the smartphone industry, we want people to open our back covers, so it is actually removable by hand. I can just put my hand in and remove it. I honestly miss the removable battery days and even the hard keys days. So now on the back, if you notice, we have the Allen key right inside. Using this Allen key, we have ensured that there is a single screw size on the entire device. Even the screen is not stuck using adhesive. You can just open up using the Allen key. One Allen key will work for everything. You can see an M.2 slot here, so you can actually expand storage with a 2230 SSD, right? This can go up to 2 terabytes. If you're into artificial intelligence, you want to do machine vision, accelerated machine vision, you could attach a Google Coral accelerator as well. Combined with a 5-megapixel camera, mounted on a robot, you now have a vehicle, right? You have a 3000 mAh battery and fast charging over Type-C. The battery, if you keep everything on, crank up the brightness to full and have a heavy CPU process running, it will still run for 4 to 5 hours. Right, and if you put it on standby, this will stay on standby for at least 10 days.
What CPU is it?
This is an ARM processor. It is an ARM 64 quad-core processor, 1.8 gigahertz.
Okay.
It has 4 GB of RAM. It has 32 GB of onboard storage. And even the GPU driver is open source, so we are not really using any proprietary drivers apart from, I think, the Bluetooth driver.
Okay,
yeah?
Cool.
We have actually started sending pilot units, right? We have been working with kernel maintainers, people who work in low-level subsystems, graphics layer, right? We are sending them devices in this month, right? And we have a person right now who is trying to bring a 4G extension on this. So because we have USB, you could just bring a 4G modem, put it inside an extension, now it becomes a 4G device, right? In fact, in future, once we see the demand for it, we may create a 4G variant of the device as well, right? We are kind of skipping that right now because the certification is really complicated for 4G, right? So we're just keeping it modular right now. So we look at this as not really an end-use device, we look at this as a platform, right? We have people coming in and telling us what they will like to do with it, right? And things that we have never been able to think of, yeah? So